I'll edit it
Perfect.
After that.
I can't edit it, but yeah.
Okay. No, it's very easy.
All right, so Dr. Devendra from Rajasthan. Tell me, doctor, how is your lockdown going on?
Yeah, lockdown is, yes, we are making videos, a lot of videos and studying a lot. You can see on my desk, many books I am reading. We are getting plenty of time for reading. That is only the good part.
Yeah.
That we were not getting during the practice, but now we are getting enough time to satisfactorily
read.
That's it.
So, Dr. Devendra, it was always very interesting for me to talk to you and discuss with you. So, I always intrigued. So, how did you get into homeopathy and what was your story basically? What is your story of homeopathy?
First of all, I came through the, what we can say, my father is also a homeopath.
Okay.
He's from,
I didn't know that. Mm-hmm.
Three batch.
Okay.
So, I was motivated from the childhood that yes, you have to be a homeopath. Bachpan se, they have taught me, yes, you have to be this.
Mm-hmm.
You have to be in this profession. You have to take over us one day. So that's how I got the legacy from the father.
Hmm.
And my sister is also a homeopath.
My God, whole
She's,
family, huh?
Yeah, and my brother-in-law, the husband of the sister is also a homeopath and my wife
so
is
when,
also
So tell me, because see, a lot of viewers are watching us and you continue to inspire a lot of people in homeopathy.
Okay.
So what, you know, what intrigues me actually is not only about homeopathy, but what time in your life you just came to know ki, haan yaar, kuch karna hai isme. When did you really come to know?
It was when I got really into the practice. When we see a person from outside that this is a good homeopath, yes, he is good job, it looks very easy. But when you get actually, when you get in the well,
right,
you
right,
came
right.
to know how much depth you are in. So, when I came to end the first year, that was so, I can say, frustrating that even with a lot of knowledge and all that, still was not able to cure the patients. That job satisfaction was not there. So, I was in touch with my Guruji, Dr. L.C. Sharma, from the, what we can say, from the first day since the admission and all that. But I've never followed him like that. But when I came to in the first year of the practice, then I need to see, ke, yes, I need some guru also. Yes, I have a family legacy, but I need an
I think
guru
it's a,
also.
I think a role of a guru would be very important. I think it's very underrated
yes,
in today's
time. Yes, it's very important.
It's very underrated.
It's very
because
important.
I was lucky enough to really find a mentor in almost every state of India. I must have traveled all across India, Europe, wherever I could. To really find the real gems. I can tell you some homeopaths. I can tell you some homeopaths you would have never heard of. But I will tell you, they are probably as brilliant as anyone else. I know of one very good homeopath in Tamil Nadu, Dr. J. Ashok. He's an absolute. You wouldn't have heard his name. He's an absolutely brilliant homeopath. I cannot say that he is any lesser than anyone you know. So there are some amazing homeopaths all across India. At least India and also the world, but I'll especially talk about India. So many of the homeopaths, they write to me that we want to learn from this doctor or that doctor. I tell them, just open your eyes and try to find in and around you. And there are just some amazing doctors. So you were telling me
when
about this mentor,
you,
mentoring. Yeah.
When I see you, I see your journey as like Gautama Buddha and the Vivekananda.
My
they
God.
Traveled the whole world and the whole India to get the knowledge and to preach the knowledge. I see your journey like that.
Really?
Because you have.
You can see when I'm sitting just next to me, there is one very very important saying here. It's written something like that. Can you see this? I'm a very big follower of him. Dr.
Yes,
Vivekan.
You have gifted me this.
So I'm a big follower of him. Follower as in not only about his writings,
yeah.
but. He made his life into an example, and I think he also spread a lot of his teachers' writings. And I also find one of my favorite places in the world to go is in. Have you been to West Bengal, Dr. Devendra? जिंदगी में एक बार तो जाना लाजिब है, आपको जाना चाहिए. बहुत बहुत बढ़िया जगह है. नॉट जस्ट द पीपल एंड एवरीथिंग, बट देयर इज अ प्लेस देयर कॉल्ड एज वेलूर मठ. इट्स लाइक द प्लेस ऑफ विवेकानंद एंड हिज प्लेस. सो इट्स अ प्लेस यू शुड विजिट. अमेजिंग अमेजिंग प्लेस. देयर इज समथिंग देयर. इफ यू गो देयर यू विल फाइंड सम एनर्जी देयर. सो आई जेन्युइनली फील दैट प्रोबब्ली वेस्ट बंगाल इज द what you can say, the holy place of homeopathy, if I may say so.
Yeah, it started from there. So it's like in what you say, it's a divine place to be in homeopathy. In
but Bengal, you should find the right person.
That we got right. Lots of practitioners.
But in West Bengal, there are many, many homeopaths. Some of them are pretty okay, but some of them are really special. So it's important to find the right person. And it's also important to find that kind of wavelength, you know. कोई कोई लोगों के बीच वेवलेंथ हो जाती है, जैसे हमारे बीच है, जस्ट लाइक दैट समटाइम्स.
या या बिल्कुल.
सो यू वर टेलिंग मी अबाउट
फर्स्ट हाफ आई फर्स्ट केम इन टच ऑफ यू व्हेन यू जस्ट कमेंटेड समथिंग ऑन. आई यूज्ड टू राइट आर्टिकल्स ऑन एचपैथी फेसबुक एंड यू जस्ट कमेंटेड ऑफ समथिंग एंड आई जस्ट सॉ यू हु इज दिस पर्सन एंड देन आई सॉ यू हैव अ यूट्यूब चैनल एंड आई सॉ दैट. And I started contacting you, like giving some messages, and then you replied. So that's how our journey began, as I remember. And the first thing you taught me, what I learned from you, that before getting in touch with you, I was also using different methods and different methodology of different authors and different repertories. But if someone asks me that, why did you give this remedy from the Clark and why from the Borik and why from the Phatak? So I was not able to give them a satisfying answer. It's after meeting from you and I learned from you that what is the reason behind it. Before it, I was selecting the repertory on the basis of my training and my instinct or my what we say memory that I have read this rubric in that repertory, so I'll use that repertory. So it was not a what we say theoretically correct, but yes, it was. I was also going good in that, but it was not theoretically correct that I can write 5 pages on that. But after meeting you and after learned from you, sent me a mail when we started initially contacting each other. You sent me a mail about when to use what repertory. So that changed me a lot also. So that I learned from
you. And new project where in the lockdown where I'm working on a book, when to use which repertory. And I'm going to invite you to send me some cases of different repertories which I'll add in the book. Because I know the passion you have on repertory is almost similar to mine. So we connect in that links also.
Actually, what I want to say that, to be frank, that from starting, my Mathematica was not very good, not at all. आज भी अगर आप मेरे से पूछो कि phosphorus के आप 10 symptom line से बता दो, तो शायद I cannot maybe able to tell. But if you ask me which peculiar rubric you see in of the phosphorus, I can tell you that in minutes. So, reading repertory initially was a what I say, it was a, I think it was a majboori keh sakte hain.
Majboori.
In starting, I started to read repertory as a, not as a passion, but as a need of the hour. That in order to treat, we need to have
quick reference. This is very interesting because I want to tell you a very interesting thing about this. That every single homeopath who I know has a base of one literature. He's not directly a master of everything. Har ek homeopath is a base of one literature. Like for example, Dr. Sarkar is main base is to an extent is Allen's keynotes and Borik Materia Medica. For example, Dr. Vijaykar's base is Bhanja Materia Medica. He reads Bhanja Materia. For example, Dr. Amar Singh Nikam somewhere also reads a lot of Clark. Dictionary Practical Materia Medica.
Yeah, he reads Clark. Yeah, I know.
Dr. Sankaran, a lot of base is Phatak Materia Medica, if you really study, because he spent a lot of time with Phatak. Yeah. So, his knowledge of Phatak, for example...
Phatak and Sensation as if... he also reads a lot of senses.
Yeah, yeah. So Dr. Sankaran's knowledge of Phatak Materia Medica is just brilliant. I'm really inspired by that. So like that with everyone, you know, you will see most homeopaths have a base of one literature, you know, wo writings ka wo ek kahin na kahin, from there the whole thing starts, I think. So I don't think that's not your weakness, actually, that is your strength. You have to look at it as a strength. But I also see, Dr. Devendra, that in near future, in coming 5 years, 10 years, there'll be a time where you're going to go through different literatures, different materia medicas you will master, and at some point you'll also start mastering source books, that is Pruvings, Materia Medica Pura, Allen's Pruvings, Herring's. So it will happen.
After many years of practice, then I came to know that after 5 or 6 years of practice, initially I started with nothing, then started with Porik and Clark repertory, then prescriber. I used a lot of prescriber because it's very easy to use, you don't have to make.
So tell me, doctor, tell me a little bit about your journey with Dr. L.C. Sharma, which is very interesting, and I told you, I wanted to come to your place to learn from
him. I was frustrated in practice, so I just went to his clinic for training, and yes, he is always welcomed. He do not take a single penny to teach his students. All he wants is dedication. He is a strict one,
tell me one or two of his cases that inspired you a lot.
I was suffering from chikungunya, chickenpox basically.
Mm-hmm.
I went for some journey, and after that I came with a lot of eruption and chickenpox.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So I was just inside his clinic, and I said, sir, dekhiye kya ho gaya, pura aise ho gaya. When you are patient, it is a different story, and when you are a doctor, it is a different story.
Agreed, totally agreed.
So I went to him, and when I was just doing like this, you can see.
I can't see, actually.
There was a bit pain in my stomach, and I was just doing like this.
Rub kar rahe the wahan pe. Can you get up and show us?
Not rubbing.
Can you get up and show us? I can't. Just, you can't.
My face. He was seeing my face expression.
Okay.
He was saying,
"Okay."
I was doing like this.
Okay.
So he gave me some medicine. Didn't told me what it is, and I took it. And in next 7 days, all eruption went off. So I randomly asked him. Although he gave his student a remedy, he did not tell them.
Right.
Basically.
Mm-hmm.
But I forced him such a lot, so he told me. And he told me, he gave me Athusa for chickenpox. A line is written in Allen's keynote, anxiety and expressions of painless and restlessness and anxiety.
Okay,
only expression. He just took
the
facial expression.
Wait for a minute. I'm just going to just quickly have a look into this so that people who watch it will remember it for a life. I hope I'm able to. So, Athusa. Athusa, Allen's keynotes.
Allen's keynotes.
An expression of great anxiety with drawn condition, well marked linea nasalis, and also features expression of pain and anxiety. Interesting. Interesting.
So that's how I came to his contact, and I started doing a lot of sessions with him, lot of case taking sessions.
Maybe one or two interesting.
He also told
one
me,
or two one or two cases that really inspired you a lot about him.
Yeah. A lady came for some respiratory illness, and it was a chronic respiratory illness. So, he took just the facial symptoms, and he gave the medicine tuberculinum. So I asked him, why did you give the tuberculinum on the respiratory? He said no. So I asked him, what, on what basis? So he said, one of his attendants said that the patient was, kuch log hote jinka structure, body weight, color, time ke saath badalta nahi. Fat, they do not get wrinkles, they do not get much of, age like wine, basically. Okay. So as they ages a lot, they
you like wine
their
or
expressions. Yeah.
Wine पीते हो कि नहीं?
It's occasional.
Okay. I used to like wine a lot, but now I stopped it. But I'm a big fan of wine. So when I go to Europe, all my friends give me a lot of wine. But now I've stopped it almost. So what happened with this? You wine बोल दिया तो I was just yeah. What to do?
So he said कि जो लोग का स्ट्रक्चर एज के साथ बदलता नहीं है, उम्र के साथ जिनका नहीं बदलता है, उसके लिए उन्होंने कहा फेस में देयर इज अ रूब्रिक फेस एक्सप्रेशन यंग.
ऐसा रूब्रिक है? वेट, लेट मी सी, गिव मी अ मिनट, आई एम गोइंग टू ओपन द लिटरेचर एंड सी इन रेफरेंस वर्क्स. Face, okay, expression young, let's see.
Young.
My God, it is there, huh? Dossix.
Yeah.
Whoopsie daisy.
So, we have natramur in that also and tuberculinum in that also.
Tuberculinum is one of the remedy, yeah. Interesting.
Yeah. So, he said ke jo log ka body structure nahi badalta, aap unko 10 saal pehle dekh lo, 20 saal pehle dekh lo, 30 saal pehle aur aaj dekh lo. You don't see any changes in them. They look as young as they were before. So, suggested tuberculinum for
interesting,
that
interesting
people. And one of the interesting cases, a case of baldness in which first thing is patches, baldness in patches.
Hello.
In young people, but all the medicines were failing. So he told me to go to the anti-myalgic. Now, how to go to the anti-myalgic? There is no specific criteria which thing to choose. But my Guruji says go for the personal history, convalescence, and his family history. So he just told me ke uski mother ko kafi time se thyroid ka problem tha. Okay. So you see in the generalities part there is a rubric family history of goiter. Only two remedies are there, drosera and tuberculinum. So from that he gave the tuberculinum baldness in young patches, in young people in patches, and with family history. So he combines a case like that. I tried a lot to learn how does he pick that, but it is very difficult to when you sit around a person with 40 years of experience, you cannot learn it in just a while.
Agreed.
My experience is you have to put yourself in, then only you are able to why a person picked that rubric.
Interesting. What are the main qualities in him that inspires you a lot? उनके बारे में ऐसे कौन सी चीजें जिससे आपको बहुत inspire होता है?
उनके सी है कि inspire के उनको नर रिपर्टरी is on his tips.
नहीं नहीं, homeopathy को side में रख दो. Other than homeopathy, what are the qualities? Homeopathy तो हम बातें करते रहेंगे. मैं आऊँगा भी आपके पास. But what are the things about him that inspire you?
Things about my Guruji inspires me that the most his dedication. He wakes in the morning in the 5 a.m. Do yoga and pranayama and goes to very religious person, do lots of pot and all that. Then he reads his Metramedic in the morning before breakfast. And then he is having breakfast and lunch and his food and going to the clinic. All day clinic. Comes home in the evening for a bit of another dinner or something. Again goes to clinic and in the night again he reads for about I have seen him reading about 12 to 1 a.m. Till 12 to 1 daily, and he reads all kind of literature, every kind of literature, like Othon Julian, and he also remembers Othon Julian also. So he also practices on lot of rare drugs. Like positronium, falcon pea, dream potency and all that, he has evolved Kubrick, and he also acquires the new literature also.
Hmm.
But on the basis of symptom, basically.
Interesting. I think one of the hallmark of a really, really good homeopath is a person who evolves himself a lot and is a person who really is like kind of constantly trying to innovate a lot. Yeah. Hello. Are you there? Hello. Are you there?
Yeah, just lost the connection.
Okay, no problem.
It's now again.
He's okay.
So, I see him a very dedicated person. In this age also, he do a lot of more than hard work than me, than most of the youngsters can do. I can bet on that.
Inspiring.
And still, having an OPD of about 100 patients a day and still reading before and after that. And what I have seen that every repetition, and one of the most remedy routines, we just take here the aphorism 153 and he says that this is the all about the 153, that single rubric. Why other medicines are not capable of producing that rubric?
Yeah.
So, this is the peculiarities of the case that was we are about to discuss. That, main aapko ek case batata hoon. Abhi, thode din pehle ki baat hai, herpes type ka case tha, aur what he said ke khujli karte 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 karte, mere ko ulti aane lagti hai, man kharab hone lagta hai, ulti. So nausea with itching, you have EP cock only. So I gave EP cock, although it does not herpetic symptom, but his what do we say, eruptions have improved after that meds. So this is the beauty of single remedy rubrics.
Yeah,
and what I have started to collecting all the single remedy rubrics of all the remedies and trying to make it in a सिंपल वे कि उसको इजीली पढ़ा भी जा सके, इस पे हम काम कर रहे हैं और शायद आगे सफलता मिले, देखते हैं।
What else, Dr. Devendra? So what is the drive for you? आपको क्या अंदर से क्या आपके लिए क्या एक drive है homeopathy की तरफ? What really kind of is the kick for you for homeopathy?
Kick is when a person comes to you with what do we say, a drastic disease and something like that. And if you heal that disease, okay, the expression on the face of that attendant and that patient, that gives the kick to me. That and that makes us realize that we have the power in our hands to change somebody's life. God has gifted us with something that we can change somebody's life. Like I had a case of gangrene a few days back, and we were about to discuss in the seminar. Hopefully, it was I think after lockdown we'll have it. But
don't tell the listen. Don't tell the case right now. Keep it for the seminar.
Okay. No,
उसका जो excitement है चला जाएगा वो देखने का.
That
so people who want to see the case have to come for our seminar that we are planning in Rajasthan.
Yeah, yeah. So no, I'm that much smart. I'll not tell you the remedy. But what I want to say, that foot was about to be amputated. Yeah. And after 4 or 5 months, we have the foot again healed up. And that expression on that old lady's face, jo duaen, jo aashirwad, jo उसके चेहरे में दिखता है कि वो अंदर से दे रही है, तो दैट इज द किक फॉर मी. या कोई माँ अपने बच्चे को बुखार में लाती है और अगले दिन वो बच्चा ठीक हो के हंसता खेलता क्लिनिक आता है, तो दैट स्माइल्स एंड दैट ग्रेटिट्यूड दे गिव टू यू, दैट गिव्स द किक.
यू आर डूइंग अमेजिंग वर्क एंड रियली इंस्पायरिंग डॉक्टर देवेंद्र. लेट्स पुट अप दिस वीडियो ऑन योर चैनल And if it goes well, then we'll make one more video, hopefully, when we get time. What do you think?
A last case of mine also, I had a sebaceous cyst here, yes. Of this much about my eye.
And, I saw that on Facebook.
That I I saw from the Phatak repertory. You can say that it was the need of the hour. I was very desperate because a lot of people pokes us that you are a homeopath, you claims to be treating big diseases and all that. You cannot treat your own thing and all that, and especially on the face. We have also seen that sister, I think.
Yeah, yeah, I saw that.
So that went away from the causticum because the single remedy rubric in the Phatak glabella notes, that is the causticum is. So that was the beauty, and after that it busted out and everything came out, and it is, you can see everything is gone.
Yeah, yeah, it's amazing, I think. Good. So what is your message to a lot of our friends in the homeopathic world who are, what do you feel?
What I feel is, basically, जो मैं जानता हूँ जो भी अपने juniors वगैरह को बताना चाहिए कि जो mistakes हमने की वो आने वाली जो generation है ना करे. पहली चीज that is study a lot. Every study, every approach you have to gather. And you have to make someone guru. You can make multiples, but at least one who is a good homeopath. And whatever you know, just share it selflessly. Do not be like a magician who will not tell his secret. But you have to be like what you said, Vivekananda. What you know, spread in all the world. That's all I want to say.
All right. So it's a pleasure talking to you. And yes.
Pleasure, that you gave your so much, you are so humble that on my request you came and you gave your so much precious time, and thanks,
it was
thanks
great,
a lot.
It was great. We'll call this as homeopathic conversations. Okay. So
okay.
All right.
Okay.
So you can put it on your channel as well, and I'll also try to put it. It'll be good. We'll try to spread it so people come to know about.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Ideas.
Thank you so much, Doctor.
Thank you. Pleasure is mine.
Okay. Goodbye.